The tear gas and the scuffles began early, all around the edge of the perimeter that police had set up to prevent a repeat of last week's violence on the Champs-Élysées.
You'd think weeks-long riots in Paris could capture the media's attention, but their coverage has been anything but thorough. If you watch CNN or read the New York Times, you'd know they're protesting against skyrocketing taxes, but that's not the whole story. The taxes are fuel taxes, and the only reason they exist is to fight climate change. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. So the vast majority of these rioters aren't anarchical Antifa members bent on turning France into a communist state. They're a bunch of working class truckers angry that they can't pay for gas because the government decided cars are evil. In at least one case, French police reportedly removed their helmets to show support for the protesters, who then sang the French national anthem. But not all of these rioters are so cordial, and government officials are comparing them to the country's 1968 uprising that ground the whole country to a halt. But what these rioters actually represent is a rejection of environmental policies touted by moves like the Paris Accords, and the timing of these demonstrations is only more proof of that. The protests started just in time to force Prime Minister Edouard Philippe to cancel his trip to a global warming conference in Poland. France gets 75% of its energy from oil and gas. And now these rioters are telling French President Emmanuel Macron that he has a choice. Stop taxing them into poverty to save the planet or face the consequences. Macron, so far, has blinked. He promised to delay new taxes, but the rioters still don't have anything close to what they want. The question is setting cars on fire and defacing national monuments the best way to get it? And now let's go to some of your comments on last week's video about Linda Sarsour being anti-Semitic. So a few of you accused us of lying that Obama actually used pepper spray on migrants at the border. But in fact, it definitely happened. Between 2012 and 2016, under President Barack Obama's administration, the US Border Patrol agents used tear gas or pepper spray more than 500 times. You don't believe me? Just search it. Lots of outlets have been reporting on this, you know? It's a fact. It's there. Daily Caller News Foundation. We wrote about it. Washington Times wrote about it. A bunch of other outlets wrote about it. It happened. Obama used a tear gas. Turns out the government is willing to use the same basic crowd dispersal techniques that they use on American protesters against migrants storming the border. Who knew? Aaron King says one pass with an A-10 will stop this bull. See, Aaron, now that is a war crime. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and share this video if you liked it and want to share it. And also be sure to like our page here at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and the Daily Caller. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can like my page in the description. Thanks for watching. Swag wagon.